Good morning, everyone, and I wish you a very happy 75th Independence Day to all of you in advance. And I welcome you all for this today's webinar on planting and aftercare in coffee. Okay, I am here with Nagaraj Gokavi, a division of agronomy, and today I will be giving a brief information on planting and aftercare in coffee. Firstly, I am going to share a few important things on planting and aftercare in coffee that we all know. The coffee is an important plantation crop, and it is a special that the perennial in nature. Under standard management conditions, the Arabica coffee can be economically productive up to 30 to 40 years, while the Robusta coffee is economically productive for 60 to 70 years. So hence, the vigor and the health of the establishment of the coffee plantations is very much the essential in order to maintain the longevity of the coffee plantations. So with this background, I'll be sharing important information on planting and aftercare in coffee. Before getting into the actual the topic, so we must understand the basic concept of planting. Here I have designed the 3 R's formula, which indicates that the right place of or the area of planting, and the right the method of the planting, and the right the time of planting. So these three are critical factors. So these are the three critical factors which influence our the vigor and the healthy establishment of the coffee plantations. The right place or the area of planting, we should give a more importance to this before one should going for the choosing the coffee area. So because the area should have all the climatic conditions or the environmental the conditions which should suit the cultivation of coffee. So once the coffee or the area is selected, then the right method we should right method will ensure the proper and the healthy the establishment of the coffee plant. So because the method it will vary, the degree of the method of planting it will vary, so depending upon the kind of the slope or the kind of the area. In flat area, so it may be a different planting method. In slopy area, so we should have some a different method of planting. So we cannot adopt a same different or the same planting method for all the kinds of slope or the hilly areas. And next and the last important thing is the right time of planting. So because so here in India, so we could come across a three major the seasons, that is rainy, summer, and the winter season. So cultivating the coffee during rainy seasons is makes inconvenient because of the rain, and the summer season, so because of the scarcity of water, the plant could not establish the properly. And the third the season, so which is by virtue of its soil moisture, so it has a very good positive influence on the better growth and the performance of the coffee seedlings. And I will start with the actual the planting and the aftercare in coffee. So with having these all operations carried out in the coffee plantations, which ensures a proper and the healthy establishments. So the flow of the webinar, today's my webinar, is goes like this. So which includes the selection of site and the preparation of land. So which is the first and the foremost important thing we need to follow. And the second comes is the line marking and the pitting. So then the next is the raising of primary shade or the temporary shade for giving immediate shade to our the coffee plant, since our coffee plants are highly the sensitive to the temperature. And next is the source and the selection of planting material, what kind of the planting material we should select and from where the material we should select. And next comes is the aftercare, the things that is planting, mulching, staking, and cutting. And next is the irrigation and fertilizers for maintaining the young coffee in order to stabilize the coffee field as well as the yield of the crop. We'll start with the selection of site. The selection of site is the important the aspect or the important parameter. So while going for the cultivation of our coffee, and the site should have a following the parameters or the following conditions. It should have a gentle to the medium the slopy area. So because the gentle or medium slopy area, so which makes us to the involve or the inculcate our all the easy operations going. Then the next comes is adequate rainfall of 1500 2500 meter or the water source. Enough water source should be there in order to support for the growth of our coffee. And the next comes is the altitude. So altitude is an important factor, so which decides the quality as well as the productivity of coffee. The minimum requirement altitude for our coffee is 600 meter. So whereas the maximum altitude requirement for our coffee is 1600 meter. So below 600 meter are the maximum. So more than 1600 meter would definitely affect the cultivation of our the coffee, both in terms of quality as well as in terms of the productivity. And the next comes is the aspect. Aspect in the sense is the direction in which a slope faces towards the north or the east. Usually the hill or the plantations are the slopes which are facing towards the northeast directions are most commonly associated with good coffee crop. Here you'll get a more clear a picture about the aspects and the altitude, how it works and how it will help to choose a very good coffee the sites. Here aspects in a simple manner is the directions. So you have a four directions like north direction, east, south and the west directions. Here what happens now while the directions or the aspects will help you to choose a very good site for the coffee cultivation. Under the altitude of so more than 900 meter, so all the aspects are the very good for the select choosing the very good the coffee plantations. So suppose if the altitude is less than 900 meter, so then if the direction of the slope is facing toward the southwest direction, so then they are not suitable for the coffee cultivation because the usually or in general, the southwest direction, they will suffer a longer exposure to the sun. Therefore, it has a negative influence on the coffee production when compared with the northeast direction. Actually, we should select the slope which are facing towards the northeast direction, and these directions will even under less than 900 meter the altitude, the directions or the slopes will have a positive influence on coffee production because the slopes facing towards northeast direction will escape from the longer exposure to the sun. So therefore, while considering the coffee sites, so we should consider the sites should facing towards the northeast direction. So then comes the preparation of land. Once the site is selected and we have a site with us and we should go for the land preparation. So land preparation, we should start with thinning out of shade trees. So because we could see a lot of shade trees and a lot of shrubs and a lot of weeds in a coffee plantations before going to establish our coffee plantation, we should give a prior importance to thinning out of the shade trees. Thinning out, it means to say that it should not be a clean felling of shade trees. We should thin out the shade trees in such a way that we should maintain at least 30 to 50 trees at a distance of 30 to 40 feet spacing in order to provide a good or a overhead a shade for the coffee plantations. Shade, it not only helps to better performance of coffee plants, but it also helps to conserve the soil, conserve the soil erosion. So then preferably, so we can retain the kind of shade trees like Atti, Basri, Jag, and other Alpigia species. This Atti and Basri comes under ficus species, and Jag is a fruit crop, and other Alpigia species can also be retained in order to provide a very good shade for the coffee plantations. So then once the shade thinning out is done, and next we should go for the slash weeding, which ensures the easy layout or the line marking of the coffee the plantation. And next comes the line marking. or the layout. So live marking is an important aspect in coffee plantations. So because if a person makes a mistake during the line marking, so it will be carried forward to the established plantations. So there, the person or the farmers will face a huge loss in the coffee plantation, because the line marking or layout makes a huge difference in the coffee production, as well as the productivity, as well as the health of the bushes. So line marking, in simple way, it is the arrangement of plants or arrangement of the seedlings in a systematic manner or a systematic manner in the given orchard or in the plantations. So line marking, it depends again upon the type of the land or topography. So we should follow the square system of planting, where there is a flat to gentle slopey the area. And where there is a steep slopey area, so there we should go for the contour or the bench terracing with the help of this A-frame. So A-frame is a important the implement which is usually preferred to line the contour bunds or to lay the contour lines across the hill in order to form a contour the line. So this contour line or the bench terracing will help you conserve the soil, as well as the soil moisture wherever the area or the hill is too much steep. So this is how we should follow depending upon the kind of the slope. And so these are all the systems we can adopt in our the coffee plantations. There are about four system planting designs designs can be adopted: square system, Quinquennes method, hedge row system, the paddock row system. Nowadays, are the most commonly followed the method system in coffee plantation is the square system of the planting. So other three systems are having some scope to adapt in our coffee plantations when you modify the plant, the canopy. And this is the schematic diagram showing the system of plantings in the coffee. It's a square system, the 6x6, depending upon the height of the plant. For tall Arabica, we can go for 7x7 or 6x6. For semi-dwarf or dwarf Arabicas, we can go for 5x5 square system. Whereas in Robusta, we can go for 10x10 in case of a selection 274. Whereas for CN2R, we can go for 8x8. So this is the square system we can follow in our Arabica coffee or the Robusta coffee, and followed by the Quinquennes method. It's a 6x6. It is like a 6x6 square system where one plant will come in the middle. So that is one plant will come in the middle, which gives you the Quinquennes method of the planting system. And the here next comes is hedgerow system of planting. Here we are reducing the spacing between the plant to plant, whereas we are maintaining the spacing between the row to row. Row to row spacing will be 6, whereas the plant to plant spacing will be 3, which gives you a 6x3 hedgerow planting system. And the next is paddock row system. So whereas here from two pairs, here pairs will be formed. Distance between the two pairs will give a 7 feet distance. So whereas the plant to plant, the spacing will be 6, and distance between the two pairs or two lines will give you a 3 feet. So 3 feet will give you a pair of rows. So this is this system especially adopted when you go for or when you planning for the mechanization in the coffee plantations by modifying the plant the canopy. And so these are all the plant population per unit area. So depending upon the planting system. So if you follow square system of planting, you can accommodate around nearly 3000 plant populations per unit area. And so if you follow this the modified the planting systems like Quinquennes, hedgerow system, paddock system, you can accommodate almost double than the square system of coffee. The next comes is the pit opening or the pitting in coffee plantations. Once the line marking is done and once the line marking layout is completed, then we should go for the pit opening or pitting in coffee plantations. By pit opening can be done by manually or with the help of pit diggers. Here, pit opening should be carried out during the month of March or the April. So these are the two seasons. So which gives you optimal conditions for the opening of the pit. After opening the pit, we should expose that particular pit for 15 to 20 days. At least 15 to 20 days we should expose. So because if any insect pest or any egg eggs will be there, they will be died. They will die due to the exposure of that pit, particular pit, to the sun. So then the optimum size of the pit should be the 45 centimeter cube, that is 1.5 feet, 1.5 feet depth, 1.5 feet of width, and 1.5 feet the height. And this is the optimum size we should follow. So because coffee is it is not an annual crop. It is a perennial crop which is going to last for 30 to 40 or 50 to 60 years. And we should have a optimum size of the pit depending upon the size of the canopy or the size of the bushes. So therefore, we standardize this fit for coffee plantation, that is 45 centimeter cube. And after the opening of pit for 15 to 20 days, we should close that pit with the help of the mixture. So that is manural mixture, that is FIM or compost can be used at the rate of 1 to 2 kg per pit. And this can be mixed with rock phosphate around 20 to 30 gram. The rock phosphate will help you proper establishment of root system. And along with the rock phosphate, the timate is the recommended at the rate of 5 to 10 gram per pit. Why the timate is recommended? So because we are noticing some problems in the field. There is some root feeding insects such as the root grubs can also be called as cob choppers, and some other root feeding insect will damage the coffee plants during the initial the planting. So therefore, to address those issues, timate is a very, very much essential in order to maintain the health of the bushes. And the next is planting dead of stakes or the rising primary shield. So the planting of dead of stakes is being done in order to give a primary shade for the coffee. As we all know, the coffee is, especially the young coffee, is highly sensitive to temperature. It needs a immediate shade for its proper growth and development. So immediate shade can be provided with the help of dadaf. So this dadaf is the leguminous tree and which grows faster, and it gives immediate shade for the coffee plants. So the dadaf stakes of around 5 to 6 feet height are planted during the month of June. June is the optimum time where we should go for planting of dadaf stakes, which ensures a better the sprouting of the dadafs and the immediate shade effect to the coffee plants. And the shade must be covered with a polythene cover. So because since the rain starts during the month of monsoon season, and the same time the planting of dadaf will be taken place, so the stagnation of water will happen. Therefore, it leads to a death of the dadaf stakes. So therefore, to avoid those problems, the polythene cover can be the fixture on the top of the dadaf stakes. Or the slant cut can be given on the top of the dadaf stakes, which ensures the no stagnation of water. So it will help to some extent. And dadaf plants are being brushed with a lime dilution during the summer season to protect from the sun scorching. So wherever the slopes, I was talking about the slopes or the direction, so which are facing towards the southwest, where they faces longer the exposure to the sun. So there it happened, the problem of the dadaf, the dying due to the desiccation or the longer exposure to the sun will happen. So therefore, in those conditions, we should brush the dadaf plants with the help of lime, the dilution. So in order to protect from the sun. Or we can wrap the dadaf plants with the help of agave leaves, or any our arecanut leaves can be wrapped in order to protect from the sun. And next comes the source and selection of planting material. So by end of June, we have the dadaf stakes, and now the August and the September is the planting period, where we should go for the selection of planting material. The selection of planting material, we have all the parameters, or we have all the ideal conditions, but when we fail to select a very good seedlings in the coffee plantation, ultimately it will affect the whole coffee plantations. And the selection of seedlings with a disease free and the vigorous seedlings can be selected, and the seedlings with stunted and the twisted roots to be discarded. So here the seedling should be selected from the certified the nursery. And the coming to the planting and the mulching. So once the good seedlings are the vigorous the seedlings are selected, then this is the time to go for the planting. The optimum time for the season for the planting of coffee is the August and the September. So again, it differs with the age of the planting. And if the seedlings are about the 16 to 18 months old, and those seedlings can be planted, those kind of seedlings we can call it as ball plantings. So that in Kannada we can tell yadu neeravari yadne neeravari gida anta karitivi. So avuna 16 to 18 months time iddaga en madbeku antandre avuna June time alli netre namge aagutte. So then when it comes to the 6 to 8 months old seedlings, so they can be the planted during the month of August or the September, so which gives you a good establishment. And while planting the coffee seedling, so we should ensure we should ensure that the apical root should be removed. So because if you remove the apical root, if it ensures the establishment or the development of adventitious root system, so therefore the proper establishment of roots or proper establishment of plant will happen, so which gives a key success for your establishment of a coffee. So then planting should not be done too deep, or it should be done just half it down the ground. And after the planting, so it should be the mulch the properly here. So improper planting so causes the death of the coffee seedlings, because once the planting is done, it should be heaped, the planting then it should be heaped with the surrounding the topsoil. Otherwise the stagnation of the water will happen, therefore the plant will suffer a serious plant will suffer from the suffocation, the respiration, the problem will happen. So therefore the plant is going to die. So therefore, so it is advisable to heap the plant at 1 inches or 2.5 centimeter so above the ground level to prevent the stagnation of water at the collar region. And so once the planting is done, and we should provide staking, we should provide, or we should give anchorage to the coffee plants in the form of the staking, because since we come across heavy winds, or the plants will be exposed to the heavy wind, so thereby the bending of seedlings or the seedlings will fall down. So therefore, not to prevent those falling of coffee seedlings, the staking should be provided, and the followed by the mulching, and the hutting should be done with the help of polythene the bags, or the fertilizer bags, or with the help of our planting material. The pongamia leaves can be used, and some ageva leaves can be used, and the proper hutting it will help to protect from the monkeys, as well as help to protect from the cattle the damage. And the next is the irrigation for the young coffee. So once the planting is done, and the irrigation ensures the proper establishment. So planting is usually done during the month of August and September, and by virtue of soil moisture, it will take around 2 to 3 months. It will take to 2 months, 3 months after the initiation of the summer season. So usually the seedlings under the field condition will come across a scarcity of water, and the desiccation of seedlings will happen. So therefore, we should make ensure that the seedling should be provided with sufficient quantity of water, that is at least a 2 liter of water per plant at 15 days interval. So must be given in order to increase the survivability rate of the coffee plantations. So if suppose the irrigation facilities are inadequate or there is a scarcity of water, then we have an alternate method to overcome the drought or overcome the problem of the seedlings death with the help of the urea nutrient mixture spray, that is urea, SSP, MOP, and zinc sulfate at the rate of 500 gram, is 375 gram and 250 gram is mixed and in 200 liter of water, and it should be sprayed at 45 days the interval during summer season, especially January, February, and this March. The season is optimum. So when the plantations having the less the water source. So this ensures a better and the proper establishment of the coffee the plantations. And next comes to the fertilizers for a young coffee. Most of the planters or the most of the farmers do not follow this fertilizer applications, or if they follow also, so they will not give in an adequate quantity. So this is the picture here we are going to give some the fertilizer recommendations for the young coffee. The fertilizer recommendation for Arabica or the Robusta coffee will vary. The Arabica coffee during the first and second year, we give a 43 gram. We recommend 43 gram per ton per year in 2 to 3 splits. So likewise, this is one urea rock phosphate MOP is one the composition, and urea DAP MOP is one fertilizer mixture, and you can also supply the fertilizer in the form of 17 or as well as in the form of 19 or, that is Sampurna. And for 1 to 2 year plants, 43 gram of urea, 50 gram of RP, and the 33 gram of MOP. So whereas for 3 to 4 year old Arabica plants, 54 gram of urea and 75 gram of rock phosphate and the 42 gram of muriate of potash can be provided. In order to ensure the proper growth of the coffee plant. Likewise, when you take the DAP, and again the urea quantity will be reduced because DAP contains both urea so as well as the phosphorus. So therefore, the 35 gram urea, 22 gram DAP, and 33 gram of MOP is sufficient to provide a nutrition for the young coffee. So when you are giving the 17 R, it has all the NPK, major NPK nutrients, and can be given at the rate of 117 or 120 gram per plant per year in 2 to 3 space. So likewise for Arabica Robusta also, we have some other recommendations. And if you want a detailed information on this fertilizer recommendations for young coffee, you can contact us. And we will give you in detail the information on fertilizer for young coffee through email or over the phone contact. This is all about the planting and aftercare in coffee. And